Fair enough.
I want to finish off those houses.
I'm just going on and checking all of the accounts to make sure that they're okay. Oh, hold on. Just checking YouTube. Okay, that's going. Okay, that's why that was doing that. Discard. I need to just swap accounts. That will do it. Oh, we have people arriving. Chelsea, Bri. Ooh. They're saying hello, hello, Shelby, hello.
Hello. It's actually a little bit gloomy today, but that's okay. Got the moody lighting on in the background just so you can see me.
Oops. Hang on. Hello for California. Hello from Germany.
Hello. This is a good time for international viewers.
Okay, hang on. I'm just sorting out the... Oh, it's on me. What a jump scare. Okay, come paint some mugs with me. Great. It's just... Oh, hello from Canada, from Washington, Arizona.
So far and wide.
Let me just quickly check the book of faces. Okay.
Is the book of faces working?
Yes, I was accidentally logged into the wrong account at first, but I fixed it. Don't worry.
Thank you.
I'm good at my job. I know what I'm doing.
That's good. I'm glad to hear.
Hi from Queensland. Hi from Chicago. Houston.
Everyone.
Well, everyone's commenting saying hello from Sri Lanka. Hello from, oh, hey y'all from Texas.
Was that your attempt?
Well, no, they said hey y'all.
Oh.
Pamela said, I wish my ceramic class did things the way you do.
Didn't really like ceramic classes because they never did this stuff. It was always the traditional stuff, and I had to like get this learning externally from classes.
And we said oh yeah, Jenny said, I love that you're alive, this is so exciting.
I'm excited. I always get so busy in the day that I'm like get distracted and then never go live. So you can thank Phoebe for that. She's been like motivating me to do more lives.
I have. I'm just gonna move these aside so we can see.
Oh yeah. I'm trying to like paint this way. You probably can't even see what I'm doing, but
it's open. I'm nervous. All the lids are off.
Yeah, I've got like heaps of colours out at the moment.
Hello from the Philippines on wow. Facebook.
Hello.
Oh, Shelby, we just have to speak up a bit because we're not microphoned.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
we have...
I'm not used to, like, yelling.
We have bought... Oh, we're planning on getting some mics so that we can do live streams.
And you can probably hear Emily over there is packing up some pottery. Oh, I'm trying to talk whilst making noise. Emily's packing pottery over there for the pottage, so... rustling around like a little squirrel over there.
Is that a bit better, everyone? Can you hear her a bit better? Otherwise, I can move a bit closer. Oh, Tammy says it's so cool that you're doing lives now.
Yay! I'm glad. I've wanted to do them forever, but in the old studio. It's been like a year anniversary in this new studio. But I wanted to do them in the old studio, but it was too unpredictable with like being outside, like because the studio was literally an outside studio. So I had no control over like weather, sound, all of that. Whereas with this new space, I really wanted to do live streams, but last year just got so busy that I just never dedicated the time to them, even though I really wanted to do them. So this year I was like, we're doing live streams with the help of Phoebe encouraging me and being here to sort of like, so that I can focus and paint and answer your questions. She's here to like help make sure and monitor the situation.
Yeah, I'm just going to chuck some of the mugs you've already painted behind you so people can see.
Yeah, so we're doing the 15 mystery mugs. I revealed the 15 mystery mugs on YouTube on Friday, and then this week's video is going to be the actual finished results of them. And the challenge is that I have to paint every single one as I found them and give myself that challenge of somewhat using some shapes that I'm not the biggest fan of, I would say, and some different shapes and ideas from you guys. And I think that some of the mugs that I didn't like have now become some of my favorites because of your ideas and how you interpreted them has just really changed how they feel for me.
Aha.
What's happening?
Thank you. There's a button on Facebook where we can, with AI, enhance your voice, hopefully.
Oh, that's my face. I don't know if you're expressing one about AI. I'm very scared of AI a little bit, but if it helps with audibility, then we will lack that for.
I'm going to try it on YouTube, but it might mute it. Give me a second, everyone. Yep, it just muted it.
You're breaking things back.
No, I'm not breaking anything. You're just putting your art in the background. Okay, back to some comments. Oh my gosh, it's 11 p.m. where some people are. They're watching you in bed.
Oh, bedtime.
Oh, can you show us what you're painting now?
Yeah, so it's like a little cottage hillside, but it's all like colourful, and Phoebe was saying it kind of reminds her of Bluey. So we're doing that. I'm getting all the colour in first, and then I'm actually just going to go in and do the windows and doors in just like a brown liner. It's just going to be like a simple colour block kind of design, and then the sky is going to be just like a nice blue. But that's what I'm painting at the moment. I'm just filling in the colours. I wasn't planning to paint this on the live, but I didn't quite get it finished this morning when I was meant to, so we're still working on this one. I've just kept the palette, like, it looks like it's really rainbow, but it's only like six colours, but I'm alternating those six colours on the houses. But we've got two greens, two blues, no, eight colours. Two blues, two greens, two yellows, and two oranges, and they're just being alternated on the houses to make it feel rainbowy but still sort of like within a color scheme.
I do love the pastels. Are they pastel-y or they just look pastels?
They look pastel now. That's the like conflicting thing about underglaze colors, is they look really pastel before you fire them because the gloss and the firing actually makes them more vibrant and bright. These are more like closer to your primary colors in a way. Like the yellows I've used is a really like yellow. Same with the blue. It's a really like electric, like very bright cobalt blue. But at the moment, I've got my plates. I've got my plates, so I can show you what colors I'm using.
Can we hold that one up close to this one here?
So I'm just actually, where's another plate? I've got another plate somewhere. Emily, would you be able to grab one of those other palette plates? Thank you. Ah! Shakes.
So which number are you currently using?
The colour I'm currently using is number 7. And then number 6 is the roof of that one. And then the blues we've got is number 10 and 11. So they're going to really pop and be really bright.
Oh, yes.
And then the oranges, we've got 18 and 19.
Oh, how do people book to paint at the Pottage?
It will go live on the 20th of April. So the website will all go live and then all the bookings will be available. We're starting with a month worth of bookings, but if it's super, super popular, we'll open it up for extra dates. We just don't know how it's going to go yet. And I also don't have the staff yet to know. Like, it's been such a exciting and wonderful project, but I want to just open it and launch it first and see how we go before opening to more dates. But yeah, the 20th is the opening date of all the bookings. So that's going to be the dates for the actual workshops are going, or like the paint your own pottery sessions are going to be on the Friday afternoons, like after work time. So they'll kind of like go into the evening, and then we'll have all day on Saturday sessions. So from morning through to the evening, there'll be multiple sessions on the Saturdays. A few people did ask for Sundays as well. So we'll just see how the bookings go. And if we sell out or if they get all booked out, then I'll open it up straight away to more sessions. It's just, yeah, it's been a, we don't even know how it's going to go yet. So we'll figure it out from there and see how that launch goes. And we'll be able to even increase the different days or different times as well, depending on what's popular.
Alicia said she wants to, they want to spend their birthday at the Pottage.
That's so nice.
It's such a great idea for a birthday, like, party,
yeah,
celebration.
I would have absolutely loved it. And I have really made sure, like, with the Pottage, that it's a space that I'm an artist at heart, and I don't like when I go to, like, a workshop or an art experience and the supplies and materials don't match up to what I want to make. So I really wanted to make sure that when we open that, we have all the right brushes and all the right things and materials so that you can absolutely paint that work of art that you've always wanted to make. So I'm really excited because, this is like a space I dreamed of before I got really into pottery and had to sort of figure it out for myself. So I hope that it is a fun and nice space for you all to enjoy. We're definitely going to learn a lot of things about this because it's like a whole new venture for the business. But I'm really excited. I can just see, it just makes me so happy to know that I'll get to see people getting creative and having so much fun and getting to see their visions come to life. It's just, yeah, it excites me a lot. So yeah, I'd love to have you there for your birthday. That would be so nice. I think I'm gonna do a blue house now.
Ooh.
Blue.
Well, I mean, you could ask everyone what they thought.
Well, I'm thinking I kind of have to do a blue house because it's next to all the...
Oh, next to the greens?
Yeah, it's next to the, like, all the other colours already, so... So I'm just doing this little house.
Cute!
And then maybe we'll...
Maybe while you're doing that, I'll show some of the other ones you've painted in people's... Like, yeah. Maybe do a teaser of one of them. Which one should we tease? I think.
And then all the people that were sending their sketches, like, there were so many cool drawings. I was like, this is so cool. It was just so cool.
This was because you said that this one was like a tin. It reminded you of a tin.
Yeah, I actually originally was just going to do like a standard tin, but then someone said, do a Milo can. I was like, duh, that's so obvious. But I'm so glad someone said that because, yeah, that really inspired that one. I was going to do little daisies on that one, but
oh.
I was like, well, Golden Wattle, like, is like that yellow branding that Milo has, so I'll do the wattle instead of daisies. It's more Australiana that way.
Gray has said that you have single-handedly convinced them to join a ceramic class.
Yay!
So they're now like enrolled in a ceramic class and they're doing it.
That's so exciting and so wonderful. I'm so happy I inspired you. That's great. I don't know if this will be like a bit of a back and forth, but what classes are, oh my gosh, what am I trying to say? My brain is not switched on today. What type of ceramic classes are they?
Oh, true.
Are they wheel throwing? Are you doing hand building? Is it a bit of everything?
And we also got a message from Hannah who said, good morning from Norway. I love your colourful mugs. I hope you sell some more online soon.
Yes, I'm hoping to. Thank you. Thank you. You've just given me like a little mental note that I need to sort out the next restock for the online shop. To be honest, haven't had a restock pretty much all year because I've been doing the pottage. It's been a very busy time behind the scenes getting it all ready, but I'm hoping that once that's all launched and the space is all up and running, that I'll be able to do some restocks again. So that is coming. I am planning for May, just to give, yeah, although May is really creeping up really soon, but I am planning for May for an online restock. Maybe I can paint some of these new mugs up for that drop.
Yeah, there was a few people wanting the Bluey inspired one.
Yeah. I really like this mug. I think that this mug is a really good shape. Like, that handle, so great.
I like the size.
Yeah, it's a really good size. It's going to have a good mil count compared to, like, oh, my dirty. I'm looking at my dirty B mug just here.
Yeah, do you mean to grab one of the other ones, though?
Maybe, like, yeah. It's quite like coffee in it. Or... Yeah. Yeah, that one. Show you a dirty stained mug. Yeah, like if you look at that, like it's going to shrink still, but the size of this one in comparison, like it's going to hold a lot. But I like this size personally because I like a smaller cup, whereas some people want like a lot bigger of a cup.
That's the mug I like.
Yeah, yeah. It's a real mixed bag. Like people all like different things.
Although sometimes I just want a little tea, so it's nice when I have a little mug for a little tea.
Exactly. Or like when you're sharing tea.
Well, you don't really want to make a half tea in a big mug. You just want a little cup for a little tea.
Yeah, exactly.
All right,
I might.
Oh, Eric makes resin jewellery.
Cool. That's really cool. I like resin works. Find it so fascinating. I like things with, like, I think I like all crafts, really. It's just so cool to see how, like, people can be so creative with mediums and create cool things and, like, how we kind of, like, undervalue and underappreciate the stuff that's in our life that's just so easily accessible.
Well, Carrie Ann is back this week. She also loves that big mug.
Oh, great. Thank you.
She was on during our last mug. Painting live
the mural.
Yeah, it was another it's another M. See, my mouth just went with mug, but mural is
mural.
And you,
I'm like struggling to words today.
Oh, like, it's one of those days. I mean, it's like that solar eclipse. There's something in the air.
Yeah, definitely.
Oh my gosh, Paulina has commented, every time I watch you I'm so happy. You remind me of me at your age. I have one question for you. Why don't you wear a smock? I live in mine.
I don't know. I used to wear aprons all the time. And I don't know. I just, for some reason, I'm looking at Emily because Emily's been a bit messy lately. But I rarely spill stuff. And, like, these are overalls anyway. And, like, that's what they're designed for, is to protect your clothes. So just because they're pretty, like, yeah, I kind of treat this as my smock. But everything washes out too, like... At the end of the day, like, clay is a really good medium because it's not like painting or anything like that where you've got it, like, it kind of stains your clothes. All this paint and clay, it washes out, so it makes it a little bit more.
Colleen loves those overalls, like the ones you're wearing now. Freya commented, I love your art. Like, I've been following you before your Gumtree series blown up online. Did you see yourself being able to be a full-time, like, artist, potter?
I think I always dreamed of it. Like, it was always like a big dream of mine to do full-time art. I didn't think it would come so quickly. I think that when I was really leaning into my pottery, COVID kind of happened at the same time, which was kind of like a big opportunity for me in a way, because with lockdown meant more people were online. So I started posting more of my videos, and I think I was just really lucky in that sense of just having that opportunity of like my videos blowing up when people needed to watch videos a lot and were at home a lot more. So yeah, I'd always dreamed of it, and I think it just came really quickly because of COVID actually. And sometimes I feel a bit guilty saying that COVID kind of made my success, but I think it did really help having people at home and that shift to, I guess, like online entertainment. Yeah, that went on a bit of a tangent, but yeah, I always wanted to do it. I just didn't think it would happen so quickly.
I mean, because of all that as well, you've now been able to do the pottage, right?
Yeah, yeah. Because I have always been asked since I started sharing my pottery online as if I did workshops, and like a lot of people in the Ballarat community wanting to anything from hiring the kilns out to doing wheel throwing, because like I was a wheel thrower to start with, and the pottery molds actually came with my pottery, my second pottery wheel that I was getting to do workshops. And it just kind of was always something I wanted to do, but never had the funding for it, because it's expensive. It's really expensive, not just pottery, but like trying to set up a space and make it so that it's nice and cozy. And I also needed to make it away from this studio just for my privacy as well, which was something that I didn't think about when I first started. But yeah, it's been a big process and something that I've always wanted to do, but it's allowed me to set up the pottage, which is good.
And what's been your favourite mystery mould so far?
Oh, I get that question all the time. I'd probably say, probably the mugs, I think, because mugs are just so universal and so great and can be used for just about anything. Any design, any work. They're just really universal in that way.
London's asked if I can read their question out loud.
Scares me.
There's a few questions in there. I was just like, how old are you? How long have you been doing art for?
Yeah, good question. Art has been something that I've always done, and I didn't really come back to it. Like, I was doing the whole go to uni, do this, do that, follow those life path things that everyone expects of you. And I didn't really fully lean into the art side until I was diagnosed with cancer. And I think I just put everything into perspective and I was like, what do I want from my life? Like, what, like, life can be so fleeting and so short. And I think that experience for me was like, oh, well, why am I wasting my time doing things that I don't enjoy and that don't bring me immense joy and immense happiness and make me feel happy and, yeah, just enjoy my life? So that's when I started doing the art side of life a lot more, and that's when I sort of fell into pottery. And so, yeah, always been creative, but I've been doing pottery for about, I'm just going to do quick math in my head, I think it's been 8 years now, but only a couple years full time. I sort of did it on the side for a long time just because, like, I just didn't want to put that financial pressure on myself by quitting my job. I wanted to enjoy pottery without having that, like, financial obligation to constantly sell my work, and that allowed me the space to build up my platform, build up awareness of my work, and build a community that loved my work without that financial strain putting pressure on it. And then once I sort of felt like it was going to tick along fine, I made that risk of quitting my job and do it full time, and I haven't looked back since. And that was, when was the COVID year when it all locked down? It was 2020, so 4 years. 4 years.
Wow. Before.
Yeah, which is wild thinking about now. Very grateful every day. Just the love and support and the opportunities this has opened up. And I'm just a big believer in saying yes to things and just giving things a go, because I'm very privileged to do so. And I might as well, make the most of these little opportunities that come up.
Claire just commented. She said, I just saw one of your YouTube shorts a few minutes ago and came right over. Your work is beautiful. I'm so glad I've just discovered you.
Oh, thank you. That's so nice. Yeah, the world is so wild. I love that shorts and reels and all of these video based platforms and even the photo based platforms have been just such a great way for me to share my love for this medium and hopefully reach people to inspire you. Or I mean, it's always ideal to have people that financially support what you're doing, but it's just great that I can reach a lot further than I guess back in the day pre-social media, where it was all just kind of a bit more like word of mouth or print publication. It's just so nice to be able to reach so many of you around the world.
Jennifer on Facebook has asked, have you ever done a series outside of your comfort zone, like darker, less cutesy?
No, but I do have an idea. I'm actually a bit of a horror buff. It sounds so weird, but I love horror movies. I love thrillers and creepy, spooky stuff. And I think maybe that's like because I get into all like the crime stuff. This is like the other part of my personality projecting out. But there's a movie coming out this year and I grew up with the first, I'm not going to tell you what it is because I don't want to spoil what I want to do, just in case I don't do it and then I'm accountable to doing it. But there's a movie that's coming out that's the second movie and I think it was an 80s movie. And I really want to do a vase that features that movie and it's all kind of like black and white, I guess like gothic horror kind of vibes. I mean, you can try and guess. I'm not going to tell you whether you guessed right though what the movie is, but I kind of want to do a vase inspired by that movie coming out. But yeah, I think that this like 15 mug, I have kind of stuck to my comfort zone a little bit with the colors, but getting your ideas helped me push new ideas and ideas that I haven't done before based on what you guys wanted to see. So that's always fun, but I definitely want to do something else like this. I've got platters as well, like platters and plates, and there's also a whole heap of bowl molds. So I'm thinking about maybe doing this again and doing Ooh. The same thing, but like with the plates. Or plates are so much more fun because they're flatter in that way, because we can do like big sceneries on them, which could be fun.
We've got a comment come in. You've made me fall in love with ceramics. So it's not a hobby I can afford at this point, but thank you for inspiring me because I'm working towards, like, she's like, you've basically introduced me to another art form that I love and I wouldn't have known about it without you. So thank you.
Thank you. That's so nice. It was really hard. People don't realize how much pottery costs to do and to set up. And for me, that was the same thing with me. It took me a long time to save up for my first kiln. I had to do a whole fundraiser for it. I did a Kickstarter. I think you can still find it when you look my name up on Google. But I did like a whole Kickstarter. And someone's a bit excited out there. I did a whole Kickstarter for it so that I could fund that, and yeah, it was small steps and I had to slowly save up for things, looking on Marketplace all the time for bargains, and it took a long time. And just start small, even if you have to go to a local pottery studio and do a class here and there, or even contacting potters in your area is always a really helpful way to go. Like, that's how I started. I couldn't find a kiln, so I contacted a local potter I knew of in the area, and she kindly let me fire in her kiln. So, like, we're usually, generally, a pretty nice bunch. I mean, every community has their funky up, but we're generally a nice bunch that are pretty accommodating and supportive of other people trying to find themselves in the pottery world. So if that helps, I hope you can find a way to access what you need.
Tori said, I glazed my penguin at like a ceramics, painter and ceramics place when I visited my niece. It was a lot more fun than I imagined.
That's so good. I'm so glad you have fun. It is, I think there's something so nice. I think that's why pottery got me hooked, was that, I mean, it's one thing to paint a picture, right, on a 2D surface, but to see your piece transform into a ceramic item that you can then use and have as part of your morning cuppa, or just something that's usable and functional, and it becomes sculptural and it almost has an energy to it. That's just what got me hooked as well, is that, yeah, it just feels more than just a painting. It's this physical artwork that you get to enjoy every day.
Linda has messaged on Facebook. Linda from New Jersey, USA. Is that what NJ stands for? I just guessed. Is that right? New Jersey?
It sounds right.
I had so much confidence going into that, but I don't know if that's true. I hope so.
I can't think of anything else. I can think it was Nebraska, but that doesn't have a J in it.
Yeah, from NJ, USA. I'm a retired grandma and came across your videos by chance. I absolutely love them. You're an amazing lady. You've overcome a lot and living your best life. We love to see it.
Thank you. That's really nice. It's gonna make me cry.
Oh.
I'm trying not to, like, I'm painting this hill. Actually, I should move on to something else. What is the time? Yeah, I should move on to picking some glaze colours for that other mug. I've got two hills to go on that one, so I feel like I can do that off camera. But let's do something else, so that we have time to
figure out. Laurie said, I think it's wonderful to create usable art. Thank you for sharing this with us.
Thank you. All right, so.
Oh, can we have a little close up on a couple of the mugs in the background there?
Yeah.
Wait, if you pass me one to do on this camera, then we'll swap around.
Okay, all right. This one's probably my least favorite, but I think it's just because it didn't really have much room for creativity for me.
Keeps focusing on you. Here we go. Stop it.
Hey. I'll try and do this. Is that, I don't even know if I'm showing everyone.
Oh yeah, that's showing. Yep. Swap.
Yeah. And this is Space Pig. I'm very proud
Space Pig.
The tail was like really long and I was like, it looks like a monkey tail.
It
and
almost looks like a chameleon.
A chameleon tail?
Yeah.
So I was just like, oh, I'm going to lean into the fact that it's a bit goofy looking. And the space pig's eating space corn.
Space pig eating space corn.
In a space world.
Living his best space life.
I'll do the two flower ones together. Okay, so this one, Phoebe's holding up the tulip one, and I'm holding up this patchwork checkerboard one. And now seeing it up close, I can see spots where I missed. But you know what? We're going to roll with it.
Swap.
The sound of bisque.
I know. It's very ASMR.
And that's the tulips. So there's a four... How many more have we got? We've got these two. These two.
Whose idea was this? I love this one.
Yeah, someone did a yellow and pink one. Oh. So I like added more colours and then added different flowers because they did the same type of flower. This is our lava lamp.
And this is the Milo tin with wattle.
So that's the lava lamp because someone said it looked like a lava lamp and then I couldn't unsee it as a lava lamp.
I love it.
Milo. Oh, sorry, that was really quick. I was like,
oh. The checkerboard one, Carrie Ann loves that one. Oh, I like this doesn't look nice, but you're right, holding it. If you go back and watch the video on YouTube. Sorry, ignore me.
It was only a drink bottle, that's fine.
It was closed.
Like, look at that conformation to your hand. It's really nice.
Oh, the tulips also looks like it's a good hand-hugging mug.
Yeah, that one definitely. And then these four I haven't actually finished. This one I'm going to do, this is that leather one. It's an ombre. So it goes from pink to purple. And I'm going to do a wash over it to bring out the details. I wasn't sure with this one because I really wanted to enhance the details a lot. And I wasn't sure whether to just do a simple glaze, but sometimes the glaze can, like, you lose some of the details in it. So I'm hoping by doing that antique wash, it will, like, bring that out a little bit more. And then this one is really half finished as well, but this one looks like a mess, okay? I know, it looks like a mess, but I've got these, which are silk screen prints. And if you guys can remember the soup mug I've already made.
I can't tell if that's a real person or not. You know when people make fake accounts and you're like, is that real or is that fake? Can everyone else see that? I think they can. I think that's fake.
I'm looking very sus there.
I'll just show you it. Because I'm pretty sure it's fake. Because I can block them and everyone can see it.
Oh, yeah.
I'm just going to I'm gonna report it. Ah! Sorry, I almost pinned it.
But yeah, these are silk screens. You can't actually, I don't know if you can see, but it's got like a picture of tomato on that. And then you push through the underglaze. So I'm going to do it over the colors, over the top. So I've got like carrots and onions and all kinds of things. So it looks like a mess right now, but it should actually look pretty cool. Got some like little leaves that I can pop on there. So I'm going to do it black. So that it's got that real, I don't know, old school supermarket feel, how it's like got those country colours, but then the black outlines. And then I'm going to put a recipe here for a veggie soup. We'll see how that goes.
Sydney has asked, well, they've kind of stated that they said that they're a perfectionist and will spend so much time at a pottery studio, like open to close. Have you ever been a perfectionist? And if so, how do you like overcome that and know when something is. Like... done. Are we ready to move on? Also trusting the process, because sometimes it's hard to do.
Yeah, I think sometimes, yeah, I do get caught up on things sometimes, and I just remind myself that sometimes what is perfect to me is like people wouldn't even notice, or like what is imperfect to me people wouldn't even notice. And as I have done more and more artwork, so I have just let myself let things be. Because sometimes, yeah, you, like, I think only you know that it's there. And the more things you create, I think the more you kind of let go of that perfectionism. I think also running a business with my pottery also helped a lot, because I was like, oh, well, you know, like, time is money, which it sucks, but it is. And so, like, being like, oh, if I spend time finessing over this one little detail, that takes away time from me doing this job or glazing this mug. And so that allowed me to go step back and go, oh, okay, like, is that really a make or break part of that design, or am I just being really finessy? And usually it's just me being really finessy. At the end of the day, like, I want my pieces to be perfect, and you want the best quality work going out in the world, and you don't want to cut corners. But I guess sometimes there comes a time where it's like, well, is this really adding anything, or is it just my personal taste wanting it to look better? And art is really subjective. So what you might think is like not perfect, someone else might think it's the most amazing thing in the world. So yeah, there's like a lot to perfectionism. I'm a perfectionist at heart, but yeah, I think doing it as a business and having that reflection of like what time is and how that comes into the business side of it has helped me sort of like go, oh, okay, I need to stop. This is enough.
Great. Is it time to pick colors? Yeah. So I've popped your water here in case you want to
Maybe I'll have a sip and yeah, we're going to pick out some glazes. I want to do the cow as well, but I think this one will be quick, so we can do this one. But I wasn't sure what to do with this one, and all the ideas were really time-consuming, and I need to get this in the kiln tonight, so it's not going to have time to have all those details. So I wanted you guys to pick out some glaze colours, and I can, like, layer them up, and we can just see what experiment we have. Maybe we'll end up with, like, a poop colour-looking mug, but maybe we'll have something really magical, so... yeah, we're going to do, so the difference between what I was using here and those ones is these ones kind of melt and run. I don't think I've got anything like it actually at the moment, but they melt and run into each other, and they're not for illustration, they're more, do you have your mug, your little copy? Yeah, it's like more like this. This is like not mine, it's just a mug, but it melts like that rather than being
illustrated. Can I hold it up close?
Yeah. But maybe we'll pick some colours.
Like that. Melty melt.
Should I maybe put some suggestions? Maybe
well, it looks very goblety. Should we hold it up so everyone can have a little close up?
Yeah.
My personal Phoebe thoughts are like yellow gold mustards.
I've got like that olivey green.
What does everyone think? This is your time. This is your time to make decisions.
Olive green. I'm just holding this olive green.
What colour do you think?
Oh, that's not. We should put this in this. We've also got these kind of like
turquoise blue purple.
Is that blue good?
You're holding up red.
Yeah, but it'll turn blue.
Oh, I thought you were just holding up bread being like, is this blue okay? Okay, so it's like the picture.
The picture. Yeah, that's the fun of glazes is they change colour.
I was like, love, you picked up the wrong one. Yellow gold would look cool, but also consider like a vine green.
A vine green, like that's all.
White gold chocolate. Ooh, kind of like a hot chocolate. Ooh, love that.
Someone said, I'm not going to say the word, turquoise.
Turquoise?
Turkeys.
Red, black, white. Brown on the inside, so it looks like hot chocolate. That's so cute.
Ooh, yeah, good idea.
I always love the chocolatey brown with a blue melty inside drip top.
These ones kind of go like a brown colour. I don't know who to show. This one's like a cool brown. It's like more of a patina though.
Okay, everybody. Brown inside, turquoise outside. That everyone's saying they love the hot chocolate on the inside as a cute idea.
Okay.
That is the consensus. Cute inside. Okay, let me head to Facebook quickly. Grey, green, grey, blue. Oh, Harry Potter. That's cute because it is very Harry Pottery.
It is.
Goblety. They have brown and yellow. That's Raven. That's Hufflepuff.
Hufflepuff.
That's what I am.
Are you?
Yeah.
What's the other one?
Hufflepuff is like cute little animals.
Yes, I think I'm Hufflepuff.
You are very much a Hufflepuff.
I feel like I'm because what's Ravenclaw?
It's like the smart.
No, I'm not Ravenclaw. I'm Hufflepuff as well. No.
Oh, so we're live on both Facebook and YouTube right now. Everyone's like wondering who else is here.
Yeah, who else is here? Who am I talking to?
Okay. Everyone's saying, yep, brown inside, turquoise okay. outside. Right. Butter beer!
Wow. Very intense.
I do love the brown inside and like that yellow outside, yellow brown outside.
That is a very
Oh, Hufflepuff is yellow and black. I thought it was brown. What's brown? Are you sure it's not brown?
Alright, I'm just going to set up my camera as well.
Oh, behind the scenes, Shelby's YouTube videos. You're seeing it here.
I just want to make sure I don't miss it because I'll probably be carried away painting.
Everyone's loving your outfit. Of course.
Alright, I'm going to do this Albanese slip brown in the inside first.
Wait, can I do it? Let me do this. This is going to be on the inside. Ooh! I like that.
I'm going to do some mixes, though, because I want it to kind of, like, have some colours. Okay, sorry. This is really big.
Everyone's getting excited that I'm excited. Like, woo, woo, this is fun! Ah! Sorry, am I yelling in your ears? Sorry. Positive on the black, I am a Hufflepuff. Okay, so Hufflepuff is black, and I thought it was brown, but that's okay. Are they a honey badger? Isn't a honey badger their thing? But that's okay.
Oh, this is very thick.
Oh, they think this is going to turn out super cute.
Okay. I'm trying to, like, make sure everyone can see.
You do what you need to do, and we'll follow you.
Okay.
Behind the scenes of YouTube, everyone. Oh, so we're going hot chocolate inside.
Hot chocolate inside.
And then dripping hot chocolate over the edges.
Oh, over the edges.
Yeah, that's what everyone liked. Where did that
come from? I was like, what's doing, Daisy? That's not a name.
All right,
so that's what you guys can, that's what
your,
the camera above here is
going to
see. I
kind of
just like.
Ooh, hot chocolate vibes.
This won't look like this when it's fire, by the way. It looks like hot chocolate now, but I don't even have anything glazed to show you examples. It's just going to be a total surprise. You'll get to see the finished results in the YouTube. I'm just going to promote that.
Yeah, right, true.
yeah, the finished results of this will be on.
Yeah, everyone's like Hufflepuff. Yeah, yellow, brown. Yeah, do it. Then you can put butterbeer inside and drink out of it with butterbeer.
I love that.
I don't know how to make butterbeer. but I assume it's like a soft drink. Is it hot or cold?
Had a beer?
Yeah.
Isn't that creaming soda with cream? What's on? Is that how you make it? Or is that like wrong?
Does
is
anyone know?
Butter beer?
What Harry Potter house is everybody? You think you're Hufflepuff, Shelbs?
I think I am. My partner, I think, is either Slytherin or Gryffindor. I can't remember.
That's two very opposites.
I know. I can't remember. I remember being shocked when, yeah, he got the results. And I was like, okay. Ooh. I need to be careful with my shadow. Keep casting a shadow on the footage.
Hufflepuff. Gryffindor.
I'm a Gryffindor.
Slytherin Claw. Can you be two? Oh, butterbeer at Harry Potter Park is creamy root beer soda.
Yeah, so
like a root beer creamy, float.
Our creamy soda, but like
Huffledore. Can you be two things at once? This isn't Divergent, everyone.
Right, that's that brown. I'm gonna go back over that and pop some more layering so that it really like drips in the kiln. The poor YouTube's getting like a weird footage of this one. I'm not running away from you. Alright. We've done a pretty thick layer of that. Oh, camera battery.
Oh. No! Oh,
just talking about it and not touching myself with it. Oh.
You almost made it. Painted glaze on yourself.
Quick little battery change. All right, so we're doing...
Edge is going to look super cute. Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Melting into like a yellow.
Yeah.
But okay. Like maybe a mustard.
Are we doing yellow?
Yeah, like Hufflepuff.
Okay.
Because right. It's very Harry Pottery.
Okay, so I got blue out, but we're doing. Do we do pumpkin?
Pumpkin sounds orange.
Oh, it's actually not. It's yellow. I'm just trying to think. Oh, the pumpkin is
this
yellow.
Is this your first live, Shelby? They've never caught you live before. This is exciting.
Yeah, not my first. Just this, trying to make it a bit more reg. Did we do one last week or was it the week before? It was like 2 weeks ago. I want to try and make them a more regular occurrence because it's, yeah, I feel like it's a nice way to connect with you guys. But I did used to do them a fair bit in my old studio, but the sound and everything just got too hard to manage. Do we do that yellow? Like, I don't really have a stronger yellow. Oh, unless we do...
Do we like that yellow? Let us know, please.
Yeah, sorry, the yellow for context. The sunflower petals.
Ah, awesome. Loving getting to see the process. This is so fun, seeing behind the... Yeah, that yellow's perfect, says Hayley.
Just gonna get all the like chunks of the other glaze out of my bristles because we don't want to contaminate. Still a bit in that. I always use like a big flat sponge for glazing because it goes on a lot smoother and cleaner than if you use anything else.
We are planning on getting a microphone for some future live streams. Yes. This is just. For now, we're going to speak loudly.
Yeah, thanks for the reminder. Thanks for the reminder. Oh, gosh. That's embarrassing. Emily's over there giggling.
Ooh, it looks so good.
I've gone that long
part. Do you want me to help with that one? Are you okay?
I think I'm okay. I just need to remember to do it. Because otherwise the people that didn't catch this miss out. Oh, well, that's there.
You snooze, you lose. Lena said, your work is amazing. Oh, oops, they're gone. Oops, it's almost midnight. I didn't realise.
I've been doing that a lot since daylight savings ended. I'm like, oh my
yes.
God, it's so late.
Tori said she's just writing down some tips for the next time they glaze something. Yes, that's gorgeous. Yep, yep, yep. Love it, love it, love it. I'm saying that, but also I'm reading the comments. Other people are saying that.
I was like, is that you or is that?
Oh, it's both. It's both. Ooh. Can you make it the brown real drippy on top of it?
Yeah. I'm going to do this. I might. I don't know. I feel like we need some color in the feet. On the foot. Like, I feel like I'll stop the yellow here.
Could we do something about, like, the goblet of fire? Could you get some fire from the bottom?
What do we think? Maybe if you guys can start sharing some ideas for the foot.
What color should the foot be? Please let us know. Do you want to do brown again? Or black, because that's the Hufflepuff colors. Ooh, gold.
So these glazes usually need about 2 to 3 coats. So what I do in my filming is I'll show you the first coat, but off camera, I actually do the rest of the coats. Because I feel like this is not super satisfying seeing it go on the second time. But I'm just gonna rush this second coat on so that we can move on to the
floor. What about a stone gray?
Ooh.
People, a lot of people are saying gold, or black.
That would be an additional firing. I don't think I have enough gold to actually cover, because the gold comes in tiny little bottles.
Oh, like black on the circular bit, and then on the actual foot, the very bottom foot bit, make that yellow again. Well, wait, what did you say? Oh, yeah, like on these bits.
Yep.
Black.
Black.
And then maybe yellow again.
I actually don't know if I've got a black glaze. I think I've only got a black underglaze, which won't give us what we want. I do have, like, someone said stone. That's like a stone. Do you want to hold that up for everyone? That's a stony colour. What were the other colour suggestions?
That was really it.
That was it.
Ooh, Hufflepuff have maple leaves in their crest. It's good to know.
There's also this brown, which is the brown of the center of that sunflower. Sorry, I'm braining. Looking at it.
Oh no, the center is in.
The center of the sunflower.
The center. Let's see what everyone's suggesting.
Sorry, I'm going off camera to look at the glaze colors.
More brown.
More brown. I'm wondering whether I mix some of this.
The green. Someone said, prettiest foot goblet I've ever saw. Oh, the one, the prettiest one I've ever seen was part of like a gold, like a flower, and had a green foot.
Do we want to do?
Oh, yeah, people saying gold, but you didn't have gold.
I won't have enough to do the gold. That would be an extra firing, which I am doing an extra firing, but I think it will be a little bit too much.
Grey looks like fun, almost like marble.
I'm just gonna do stuff without your permission, everyone.
What are you doing?
I'm just adding a little bit of a, like, really deep down there, so that it has like a mixy blendingness. It will look like
blend.
It will look like hot chocolate still, hopefully.
Yellow to red, maybe. Is it Dina? A tall mug also reminds me of when Ron turns his rat into a water goblet with a broken wand. What colour was the goblet?
Oh, someone sent me a picture of that in the box. It was like a browny, like tawny colour. It had a like rat tail on it still. Alright, I've just done some like
spots. Haha, Shelby, without permission. Yellow to orange, maybe, then brown again.
Alright. And now I'm gonna go back in and add these drops.
Yes, the hot chocolate dripping.
I'm just like, it's hard to know what it's gonna look like. It might react, but
in what way?
Sometimes the different glaze brands can react depending. But
just, like, not work?
Yeah, but we're just going to go with it. If it doesn't work, we'll just make another one. Should we do the handle a bit more like... Look, I'm just going for it.
Go for it. We're trusting the process. We're trusting your process.
I'm just going to pop it around that. It might not like me.
Okay. We'll like you. Oh, yes! Can we hold it up? See the vision?
Okay.
So that's what we'll like melt together?
Yeah. Let's add a couple more colours on the inside. I'm going to try this chai. This one's actually called chai, which is very fitting for a mug.
And that's so that it will like melt together. That's cool.
We'll just see. We're just going to play.
And just, can you put a little more brown on that a little bit? Was it going to melt?
It'll melt.
Okay.
Yeah. Is it annoying you though? Because I'll fix it.
That's okay.
I'll fix it.
No, we just talked about perfectionism and like trusting the process. See,
yeah, this is me letting go of my perfectionism, but I'll fix it for...
Thank you.
I think glazes are really fun if you are a perfectionist, because you have no control, and that's really fun. Alrighty, let's do.
Oh, the dripping brown makes me think of Winnie the Pooh's honey pot.
Ooh,
I love that.
I've got a glaze called Milk and Honey, which I could put on the bottom. It's like a speckledy gold honey color.
Yeah, maybe.
Maybe that's because that kind of makes everyone's
suggestions. Yes, it really does.
All right, this one is not red. It's like more of a brown. I'm just going to add it, okay? If it fails, you guys can all be like, saw you fail there. I don't know what objective that would have, but we're just going to...
Oh, yeah, that would be so cool. I think that's about the honeypot thing. Perfect, love that idea. Oh, yes, that'd be cute.
All right, people let's do that. I'm just adding this for some more like chocolatey texture. Alright. I'm gonna add the honey.
Can you show us the honey colour?
Yeah.
Wait. Is it gonna be like green or something?
Yeah.
Really?
Oh, well, it's not like, yeah, it's what you're getting at is that it doesn't look like how it looks when it's fired. So,
what color do you think it'll be? Quick, go now.
It's actually kind of close to what it would be, but...
Pink.
It's actually just white. Oh. It's a bit boring.
Do you have a picture on the front of it?
No, this one's one that's a bit of a...
Oh,
that's it opens. It's It's one of those ones that's all stuck. Just trying to think if I have anything in here that's got milk and honey. Oh, I need to add some water. Hang on.
Oh, she's back.
It's a bit,
Yeah, you don't have anything that shows us what it looks like fired?
No, I don't think so. I've got test tiles in the old studio still, but... I'm looking around, like, no, I don't think so.
Any pictures on a website I can bring up?
I don't think so either. Oh. Sorry. I can't remember the last time.
I guess you'll just have to watch the YouTube video.
Actually, I think I did do it on the honey. I did it on the bear jar. It was like mystery mall number 40.
You'll just have to like watch the YouTube video to see the ending. Not hooking you through or anything.
Okay, this is either going to go everywhere and be very entertaining or just be a standard shake, but I'm going to shake it. Oh, these bottles. This brand is really good, but their bottles. Like, why is this actually really hard to close? Okay, we're gonna do that later because it's not working. I'll have to just use this as it is.
Do you want me to try? Can I let the first go?
Yeah, probably. Just needs a bit of a mix because it's been sitting over the summer and it's dried out. That's the good thing about glazers is you can add water and save them. It might be because the lid's all caked up.
Oh. I genuinely did not mean to get that the first go.
Did you all see that? Was that in frame? Did you see that?
Getting a workout today, shaking.
Lol, yes we did.
I promise I'm not going red from embarrassment. I'm going red from shaking that.
Sure. I mean, what would you do without me?
I don't know. Probably cry.
Aww. Everything, yes.
Do I start from the foot? Like, are we gonna leave this yellow? I feel like we need to add stuff, but maybe I'm just being a bit of a like overdoer.
Okay, just make sure you're recording that one.
I'm adding it to the foot. Ooh. She's not going on great. Oh, this is hard stuff to work with. It's not, I needed to mix it a bit more. Oh, it's not satisfying at all. I think I need more water. It's very clunky.
Yeah, do. Oh, she's back.
It's a quick little water trip.
Oh, if you add a marble into the container, when you mix it, it makes it easier to mix.
Oh, yeah, true.
That's actually a life hack. Thanks to, darling you.
Thank you. That would be neat to have a resonant studio marble. We are babysitting a cheeky little puppy today, so you might have heard a bit of barking today.
Do you want to see the pottery puppies? I'll show you a picture.
Alright, that's going on heaps better. Oops, I forgot about
this. This is behind the camera today. How cute. Look at this. So what's behind the camera today? The pottery pups. Here you go, you can see too.
Those aren't the ones that are barking.
No,
that one outside.
This one. This distinguished gentleman. Look at him. He's the one barking. Bark, bark.
He's usually not here, but We're just babysitting for the
day. He's being a distinguished gentleman. He's the one barking. But look at him. Look at his little cross paws and everything.
Obsessed. Alright. That is really thick. That's thick. But we're just going to roll with it and see what happens, because that's half the fun, right? Do we add a little bit more yellow before I finish this one up? Like a little bit more onto the here or even in the middle? Like, what are we thinking? Is it finished?
We've also got, what do you think? It's hard to know without it going.
Well, that's the fun. That's the
fun, I reckon. Ooh, Patty said live viewing is cool. It's like real time, like unedited, which is like they're really enjoying that.
Unscripted.
Yeah, just like obviously your YouTube videos are edited, so it's nice to see.
And it's also nice having people part of the decision-making process.
Oh, Hayley thinks it's finished.
You think it's finished? Oh. I'm trying not to add.
But you're right. It, like, whoever said it's like Winnie the Pooh. Could you make two yellows swell when they melt?
That's what I'm wondering, whether there's like another yellow I can blend in with that. Ooh, I know. I'll get you to pick though. There's three yellow colours that I'm just going to pop a little dollop ring around the base to make it sort of all around the centre even.
Ooh, no. Jenny suggested that, by the way.
Thank you, Jenny. I think that's what I'm leaning towards. So I've got three yellow colours. Although one of them kind of goes a bit reddy. It's more like an orange. Yeah, it's more like an orange. I'm actually thinking about adding just like one more bleedy? What's a good way? Runny?
Blending?
Runny? Blendy?
Melty?
Melty colour. Another colour that melts around this ring so that it kind of like goes into the yellow. So I'll get you guys to pick based on the name. So we've got saffron.
Ooh.
Mimosa.
Ooh.
And citron.
Okay.
So we've got three options. I'll let you guys pick whilst I do a quick little tidy up before moving on to our next
Citron. One says citron. Carrie Ann. Oh my gosh. Bronwyn says saffron. Hayley says first one. Laurie says saffron. The Lily Dragon says saffron. Saffron, SJ. Mercy, saffron. Okay, so everyone wants
saffron?
Yeah.
And now, should I put it on that top ring, like I said?
Oh my god, literally everyone says saffron.
Okay, let's do saffron then.
So it's Tanya. Aisha, Kayla, they all say saffron. Rach says citron.
Okay, I'm going to go saffron because it sounds like we got saffron.
Dina asked, I don't know anything about layers of painting. That being said, does a thick layer affect the quality of the colour other than its dark colour or vibrance? Will it crack if it's too thick?
Glaze and underglaze are different. But we've actually done these for the pottage. Actually, Phoebe, whilst I'm mixing this, would you be able to water that down a little bit?
Water?
Yeah. Maybe like a quarter of a cup. Yeah.
A quarter of a cup.
Yeah. I should have just done it because now I'm just watching, overseeing. I think that's good, yeah.
That was my quarter.
So, with underglaze, the coats, I'm going to hold two up that are really prominent. The coats do impact it, how it looks. So you have one that's more like lighter, I think. And then when you've got the three coats, you get that really nice opaque color, which is what I like to work with. But some potters like to use this kind of like coating because it gives it this nice watercolor effect. So underglaze is like that. The more underglaze you add, it can start to repel if you add too much, where it starts to like crack off the piece a little bit. But you have to like layer heaps and heaps of layers to get that. Like it would take like at least seven layers, I think, to do that. has happened to me in the past when I've had like, when I keep adding details and I just keep adding colour on top of colour on top of colour, it can repel a little bit, but it's very rare that that happens. So that's under glaze. With glaze, you can add as much colour as you possibly can. It can impact the food safety of it if it starts to crack. So when you're making something that's for food safety, you want to make sure that you're using food safe glazes and food safe clay and firing and vitrifying. There's a whole thing around food safety. But when the glaze cracks because you put too much on, that's when it becomes somewhat like food unsafe, because those little cracks are spaces for bacteria to grow and build up on. So with glazes, they recommend 2 to 3 coats. Every glaze is different and they have it like on the side. And also any glazes that you make, they'll usually have instructions on like how to keep it a food safe glaze if you're making it from scratch. But yeah, they all have the signs on them. But if you want to layer and do something more sculptural, you can add as many layers of glaze as you want. And then you can get some really cool gloopy, crackly, bubbly type reactions happening. I hope that that kind of answers your question.
I hope I haven't added too much water to that.
That's fine.
Is it? I can't ruin it?
No. It'll just dry out. It'll just dry out again. And then, okay. Yeah. I might just Google. Oh.
What you doing?
That's really satisfying.
Alistair asked.
What you doing?
What you doing?
Just glazing. How are we feeling? Like, do we want to keep going after this?
I reckon we'll do this mug and then everyone heads to the YouTube channel like this weekend to watch the results.
Can we pick up some decals though before everyone
goes? Yeah.
I think that would probably be the only thing. I mean, I was going to do the cow, but I think I can do that without help. I've had a few suggestions for that. So I'm just adding this somewhat yellow color to the drips, and then we'll pick out some decals for the teacup, because I kind of really want your help with that one, because I'm overwhelmed with choice. So decals are a additional overglaze firing, kind of like the luster firing. So you first bisque pottery, then you glaze pottery, and then you can do an additional firing, which is this decal firing, and they come as pre-printed pictures and you can apply them. So I kind of wanted to try them out for the first time, because I think that there's potential to do like a decal session at the pottage at some stage, so I want to get good at using them before I actually do that. So this is going to be my first attempt trying them. These are all vintage decals, ranging from like, I don't know, I think I saw some from the 70s through to the 90s. So I want you to...
We are running low on charge, so that might work perfectly to...
Wrap it up, the decals.
Yes.
Yeah. Cool. All right. I'll show you the decals. And then...
We can swivel if you want.
So that one's done. We're going to pop it in the glaze kiln and hopefully it does not... do anything naughty.
Well, if you want to see the result.
Yes, if you want to see the results, it's going to be in this week's YouTube. So, let's... And that should be out at 8:30 on Friday. 8:30 p.m. AEST. But we'll just see. Because we're under the pump to get 15 months.
Oh, everyone's loving that information that you're giving them.
About the glaze?
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. Cool, I'm glad. I'm glad it's helpful. Sometimes I feel like people gatekeep pottery information. It's really hard to find good information. Like, I follow some people and like, people are asking me questions. Can you, like, it's not hard to just like let people know what you're doing. So these are all decals. We won't use the that one literally says toilet on it. We won't use that one. It says toilet. But we want to use some cool ones to put on our teacups. This is our teacup. I've already glazed that with like a nice sort of cactusy green color, but I kind of want to add maybe some flowers or see if we've got some berries or something in here to add on the side. So these kind of peel off like a temporary tattoo or something like similar to that, like the paper. So you put this in the water and this will come off and slide off, and then you slide it onto the glazed pottery. So I've got so many of these, like look how pretty they are. They're kingfishers.
Okay, so we'll hold them up and you guys comment.
Yeah.
Let us know which one we should use.
that. We can't use that one, but it's just like such big pictures. All right, let's find some.
Is there a frog detail? Chantel wants a little froggy.
Okay, these ones are all too big, so. Alright, so we've got some little flowers there. Maybe I'll pop like a good pile. Yeah, do you want to help?
I'm helping.
Yeah. So many. Oh, look, doggies!
The Bernese Mountain Dog.
Oh, sorry, I'm getting distracted by how cute things are.
You distracted me with Bernese Mountain Dog.
Dinosaur!
Rawr!
I like these ones, though. I don't know. I think they're too big. Oh my gosh, there's so many. Maybe what I'll do, I'll pull out a section.
Look at those.
That's really sweet. I think it's big enough for everyone to see it once. Yeah, they're little.
Oh my god, look, there's little pears. Wait.
Oh my gosh, they're cute. All right, let's maybe pick out a couple of
bunnies.
What have we got in there?
Bunnies.
Sorry, this is probably really like...
They are cute. Pull that out. Pull it out. Pull it out. Oh, wait. I like the pine cones.
And pine cones and clogs.
Can you just put them on the list?
All right. We're doing a short list for you, actually, because it's like there's so many.
Oh, yeah. Look at the comments. Ladybugs. Is there a ladybug?
Oh, let's have a look. I'll try and find some.
I found Santa Claus.
I really wanted fairies, but I don't think we're going to find fairies.
Yellow flowers.
Yellow flowers. I'm going through these. I found fairies. I found fairies. Oh, strawberries. Guys. Fairies. I think I'm not even going to let you pick.
You can't do that to them.
The fairies are so cute, though. They're dancing. Okay, fairies. Maybe I influence them by my excitement and they're going to pick fairies anyway.
Look at the little cows.
Okay, did someone say ladybugs?
Bunnies. Oh, fairies would be perfect. Fairies. Roxy said fairies.
Got lots of flowers. These are all like
there's a dragonfly or
oh, that's a bit problematic. It's a very old school characters.
Oh, they're cute. Look at this puppy.
Oh, there's some beautiful like blue flowers too, which is so cool. Oh, I don't think we've got ladybugs.
Dinosaur, bro!
Right, maybe we just go with the short list that we've got. Maybe, do you want to look at that bottom?
Ooh, hummingbirds.
Ooh, there's more. Okay, I'm going to get that out.
Dancing fairies, 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 yes, 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 fairies, fairies, fairies. She was a fairy.
There's this sheep too.
Nah, everyone on YouTube says fairies. Fairy emojis, fairies.
Facebook. We've got to give Facebook some love too.
No one's commenting on Facebook.
Ah. They've all headed off.
Fairies and flowers. Fairies, fairies, fairies. Fairies it is. Fairies.
Okay, cool. Alright, let's do that then. So I'm thinking I'll do these fairies. Hopefully. It doesn't even feel like a detail sheet. We'll try these fairies, but if the fairies don't work, I've got like lots of little dainty flowers that I'm thinking could be really cool, and we might do like a bit of a collage-y type situation.
Hummingbirds, fairies, fairies, fairy, fairies, fairies, fairies.
Okay, cool. All right. We'll do fairies, and we'll pop them on the teacup once it's all placed. Oh, yeah. All right. Well, if you want to see the finished results of these mugs that I painted today, They will be in this week's YouTube video coming out Friday evening. And
or Saturday.
Or Saturday. We're just going to see how the kill firings go. Because it's, yeah, it's pushing time. But, yeah, it'll be out this week regardless. Thank you so much for joining me. It was so fun. I hope you had fun. Yeah, I want to do more of these. So thank you for joining me. It's really encouraging. And I guess I will see you next time.
Head to Friday. Head to YouTube.
Yeah, Friday, YouTube.
Wait. Oh.